Thanks for joining me today to talk about COBie4Designers. If you're just getting started learning about COBie, it can be quite daunting. In fact, the main COBie webpage probably has decades worth of information. This video will help you get right to the heart of the matter. The first thing to know is, what is COBie? COBie is the list of all the managed and maintained assets in the building, so that's spaces and equipment. COBie is an information exchange format. That means that there's information, the information about the managed assets in the building, and there's a way to exchange that information. That's the envelope, the packaging of the COBie data. In this video, we're going to focus on the contents and not the envelope. The requirements to deliver COBie data are phased in over time. That's a good thing because we don't know all the COBie data at the beginning of the project. Initially, we'll know information about the blocking and stacking of various spaces. Then we'll begin to explore the actual walls and the architectural configuration. And by the time we get to the construction document stage, we have everything we need to build a building. So at the architectural programming stage, the COBie file simply contains the spaces and the equipment that are required to meet that architectural program. COBie really can be thought of at the programming stage as just a compilation of all the room data sheets. During architectural design, COBie data can be thought of the compilation of all the architectural schedules for doors and windows and spaces, as well as the plumbing and lighting fixtures coming from the reflected ceiling plans, and so forth. At the construction document stage of design, COBie includes both the architectural schedules for room finishes, windows and doors, as well as the schedules produced by any design consultants, such as mechanical, electrical, plumbing, and others. During construction, the builder simply fills in the outline of all of the designed assets produced at the construction document stage. The outline is filled in with the attached documents from approved submittals, as well as specific information about installed products and equipment. It's probably important to note at this point that COBie is about the information content of the assets in the building, the scheduled data, and the as-installed information. COBie dataset should not contain complex building geometry. It's not intended for that. It's simply an exchange of the information about building assets. Now that we know a little bit about what COBie is and is not, let's see how an owner might include COBie in a design contract and what that means for you as the designer. Here's the draft COBie specification currently being considered by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. In this specification, COBie-specific submittals are required any time the designer delivers paper drawings. There are three components to any COBie-specific submittal set. The first are the COBie data file, the next is the COBie data quality control report, and any documents identified in the COBie file itself. During the design stage, the documents required are simply the list of all the drawings and the design reports. So now we know that COBie data during design is simply the list of all of the assets in the building as described in the schedules, and the delivery happens every time paper drawings are required. Now let's talk about how COBie data is produced and the workflows designers need to think about. Since COBie data comes directly from the schedules on the design drawings, designers need to think about those workflows that they use to generate or consume schedules. Some schedules are very explicit about the names and locations of each individual element. In the finished schedule, we have the list of each of the rooms uniquely identified by room number and the name of the room. In the fan schedule, we similarly have a uniquely identified unit number for each of the fans plus the room number that they're located in. COBie requires that assets, whether rooms or fans, all be uniquely identified. This is perfectly within keeping of architectural and design practice, as you can see from the schedules shown here. Other types of schedules identify assets by type. In this instance, we have a plumbing fixture schedule and a lighting fixture schedule. In these cases, the designer can use the capabilities of their design software to automatically assign unique labels to each individual fixture, or they could manually do it themselves, depending on the nature of the specific asset. So the real workflow consideration for designers is to simply ensure that the data from the schedules appears in the model and can be extracted to get the COBie information when the drawings are produced. a design workflow that creates drawings and then allows specifiers to paste the schedules on the drawings is going to be much more problematic when it comes to the automated production of COBie data. COBie also requires each type of asset to be classified. This classification is simply a way for owners to use information across different buildings and compare apples to apples. The COBie specification itself does not specify which classification scheme an owner should use, but provides a default if an owner has not specified. The default in the United States is called the OmniClass, and it is a product of the Construction Specification Institute. The technical details of transforming your design into a COBie data model are all specified as part of the United States National BIM standard. Later videos in this series will provide much more detail about the specifics of that standard. In the meantime, let me just give you a general overview of how COBie data is transformed from your drawing schedules into one of the formats for COBie, which is a COBie spreadsheet. Transforming this finished schedule into COBie data requires two steps. The first is that the name of the room and its description be transferred to the COBie space worksheet. The second part of the transformation is to take the columns in the finished schedule and move them to the COBie attributes worksheet. Here's an example of transforming a fan schedule into a COBie worksheet. As before, two steps are required. The leftmost columns of the fan schedule contain the name of the fan and its location. That information is placed in the COBie component worksheet. The second step is to take the remaining columns of the fan schedule and simply transpose them into the COBie attributes worksheet. In the United States, the specification of COBie simply requires that the data delivered match the information provided on the design schedules. So then the real question is there software that can be trusted to do this so that if you put the design schedule data in the building information model or CAD software, that it will properly come out in the correct COBie format? Yes, software for planners and designers has been rigorously tested by the Building Smart Alliance. This testing began in July of 2008 and continues to today. You can find more information about specific software at the Building Smart Alliance Means and Methods page. I hope that this video has answered some basic questions that you might have had about COBie for design and for design workflow. Thanks for joining me today.